Hello, my friend. As we've noticed a resurgence in the need for space updates, you're at the correct place. Alright then, you're back with us, and as usual, we're ready to provide you the most cutting-edge information available in the space industry. We'll start with the issue of the liquid nitrogen leak onto wetlands around SpaceX launch pad before rocket test explosion, then we'll cover the update regarding the Dragon capsule docking with the space station on SpaceX's 25th cargo mission, and we'll finish with an update on how NASA and Roscosmos, its Russian counterpart, finally reached an agreement on ride-sharing on Friday after months of back-and-forth negotiations. Let's start with our first update. Liquid nitrogen has leaked close to SpaceX's launch site in South Texas, federal regulators confirmed on Thursday to Bloomberg. When launching rockets, Elon Musk's aerospace company utilizes liquid nitrogen as a coolant. The chemical can cause suffocation, cold burns, and frostbite, according to academic research, and has a boiling point of around minus 196 degrees Celsius, which is minus 320 degrees Fahrenheit. In a video that was uploaded on YouTube on Saturday, RGV aerial photography can be seen flying above marshland that's turned white owing to liquid nitrogen leaks from one of SpaceX's facilities at the Boca Chica launch site. Both the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, Galveston Office, and the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department verified the liquid nitrogen leak. As per the agency's statement, the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department is aware of the liquid nitrogen discharge that occurred fully within the boundaries of SpaceX property. The discharge did not impact Texas Parks and Wildlife Department property. 3 days prior to SpaceX's Starship rocket booster prototype catching fire at the launch site, the leak allegedly occurred. Following the incident, Musk tweeted, "Yeah, actually not good. Team is assessing damage." But later, Musk confirmed that damage is minimal. Now let's move to the next update. The International Space Station, or ISS, received more than 5,800 pounds, 2,630 kilograms, of supplies on Saturday, July 16th, when a SpaceX Dragon cargo spacecraft docking with the space station on SpaceX's 25th cargo mission. The robotic Dragon was launched on a two-stage Falcon 9 rocket on Thursday evening, July 14th. It was launched from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The Falcon 9 rocket successfully launched Dragon into low Earth orbit, and the SpaceX drone ship safely landed the rocket's first stage. The current mission, known as CRS-25, is SpaceX's 25th cargo voyage to the ISS for NASA. Since the company's first operational ISS cargo voyage in 2012, the quantity has grown at a moderate but consistent rate of roughly 2 per year. Naturally, SpaceX has a significantly greater total launch frequency. CRS-25's launch was the 30th Falcon 9 launch so far this year. In contrast, SpaceX only carried out 31 missions in total in 2021. Benji Reed, Senior Director of Human Spaceflight at SpaceX, claims that the corporation plans to triple that number by the end of this year. The other two Dragon flights this year, both of which launched in April, had crews. On a flight coordinated by the Houston-based corporation Axiom Space, one, designated AX-1, took paying customers to the orbiting lab. The second was Crew 4, SpaceX's fourth astronaut mission under contract with NASA. Scientific research accounts for around half the weight that Dragon carried to the ISS on CRS-25. According to NASA officials, the mission dropped off a few more research projects and contributed to close to 40 continuing ones on the orbiting lab. The effects of microgravity on the healing of sutured wounds are the subject of one study from the European Space Agency and the University of Florence in Italy. Another, from the University of California, San Francisco, will investigate how the immune system affects aging and the body's capacity for self-healing. A specific kind of biopolymer, concrete, is also the subject of research, which may help in the quest for lunar construction materials in the future. The Earth Surface Mineral Dust Source Investigation Experiment, which was loaded into Dragon's trunk, will be unloaded and installed to the Express Logistics Carrier 1, an exposed external payload compartment for experiments and storage using the ISS's robotic arm. Before returning to Earth with a splashdown off the coast of Florida, somewhere in mid-August, Dragon is anticipated to stay attached to the ISS for roughly a month and be loaded with equipment from the station. Let's move to the last update for today. After months of back-and-forth negotiations, NASA and Roscosmos, its Russian counterpart, came to a ride-sharing deal on Friday, allowing American and Russian astronauts to once again share space on the same ship. NASA astronauts have secured two seats on two different launches of Russia's Soyuz spacecraft, with the first one scheduled to depart from Kazakhstan's Cosmodrome in September. And for the first time ever, Russian cosmonauts will board one of SpaceX's relatively new Crew Dragon spacecraft on at least two upcoming SpaceX missions to the International Space Station. In September, NASA appointed astronaut Frank Rubio to the Soyuz mission, and astronaut Laurel O'Hara will fly on a subsequent Soyuz trip. According to NASA, Andrei Fedyev will go on another SpaceX mission in the spring of 2023, and Roscosmos is sending cosmonaut Anna Kakina on SpaceX's voyage in September. The agreement was verified on Friday by NASA and Roscosmos. The seat swap arrangement, which does not entail monetary exchange between the nations, has been hovering over NASA and Roscosmos for months, despite escalating hostilities between the United States and Russia over the conflict in Ukraine. As per NASA's statement, the station was designed to be interdependent and relies on contributions from each space agency to function. No one agency has the capability to function independent of the others. A ride-sharing agreement with Russia, according to a statement released by NASA on Friday, was essential to ensuring the ISS's continued safe operations. A seat swap arrangement would make sure that both U.S. astronauts and Russian cosmonauts would still have access to the space station in the event that either the SpaceX Crew Dragon vehicle or the Russian Soyuz spacecraft encountered problems and were forced out of the operation. In the two decades of the ISS's existence, these ride-sharing agreements have been typical. For instance, after NASA ended the Space Shuttle program in 2011, American astronauts were forced to only rely on Soyuz spacecraft seats to reach the International Space Station. Only until SpaceX's Crew Dragon went into operation in 2020 did that dependence end. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.